What it do, YouTube? This your boy, Chop and Dre, back at you once again with another exclusive, man. I just wanted to come and vlog for you guys for a little minute, man, about my barber journey. Right now, as of Monday, I have 1,119 hours. It's been a beautiful ride, man. I enjoy the people. You know, I enjoy my teacher, Mr. Travis. I enjoyed all the guys I met, you know, the bar bros on the way. It's been really cool, man. It's been really adventurous ride, man. You know, as you go into through barber school, man, life happens. It's just a good ride, man. You know, I'm excited. I'll be done in October or November. I'll walk in October. Man, it's just so real now. You know what I mean? I've been doing this for 2 years, man. So that's an advice I would give you guys, man. Make sure you guys know what program you're getting into. At first, I didn't know it was a two-year program, but I stuck with it because I had to work, and I had a lot going on in my life then. I became a father. It's just been a lot, man, you know. Speaking on that, as becoming a father, man, it really was one of the things that pushed me to get into barber school, man. I wanted to leave something for my kid, for my baby, a legacy, you know what I'm saying? And show us something different. You know, you don't have to work for somebody. You can work for yourself and be your own boss. And that's what I wanted to instill in my kid. So, you know, doing that whole ordeal, man, it was really rough, man. Being away from her, and you know, I wanted you to let you know, baby, I love you with all my heart. Daddy loves you. And, yeah, you know, she was one of the biggest things to push me into barber school, man. So, from that, baby, I thank you. You made me grow up a lot. Daddy, appreciate you. With Father J just passed, and I just want you to know that. And, yeah, man, you got me getting all sentimental, but back to the barber stuff, man. So, yeah, man, make sure you know what program you get into. I had the option to be in a day class, so it would have been from like 8:30 to 2:30. So total hours you get in the day class is 6 hours. In nighttime, you only get 4. So we basically almost half the time, and they going to school on daytime for 6 hours, Monday through Friday, and on night class we get there. You know, it's only 4 hours from 5 to 9. So, you know, basically it's, you know, part-time. And it's cool, man. We get 4 hours a week. Man, 4 hours a day. We just go 16 hours a week. We go through Monday through Thursday. So, man, make sure you know what program you're getting into. Make sure you, you know, do your research before you decide to go and commit to go to a barber school, man. That's my number one advice. And number two, I say, you know, stay down till you come up, man. Trust the process, man. You know, don't be in such a hurry to, you know, get your fade right and, you know, get your facials and your practices right, man. You know, you want to make sure you are ready to embark on the journey. You know what I'm saying? I seen a lot of people come and go, you know, in my class. You know, they quit or something happens in life where they have to stop, you know what I'm saying? With that being said, you know, that two-year program, that's a long time, man. Anything can happen in 2 years, man. So I say, you know, like I said, do your research, man, and just stay consistent and persistent. You know, if barbering something is you really want to do, you got to work on it every day. And that's what I mean by stay 10 toes down, man. Trust the process, man. Your fade is going to get right. Your barber eye, your tonsure, your eye is going to get right. You know, you're going to be able to, you know, hone on your skills, man. Make sure you know, the number one thing to get is the book, man. That stuff is very important, man. I didn't know barbering was that important. The book information was that important. I thought you just cut your hair. a lot of people believe that you're just cutting hair when you get in school, and that's not true. If you have a good teacher like Mr. Travis and Miss Pete, man, I commend them, man, them people, man. They really look out for you, man. They teach you everything you need to know. It's up to you to grasp it. It's up to you to want to do what you know. Nobody should have to make a grown up do what they want to do, what they're supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? So that's their approach at it. So they're gonna give you all the tools that you need to succeed, but it's on you. You know what I mean? Like I said, man, it's something you have to be able to figure out that you want to do. And another thing that's important is don't be afraid to get on the mannequin, man. A lot of guys quit because they think it's gay or something like that. It's not, man. And you know, this it's not. It's something that needs to be practiced for your practical. It's something that you have to go through. You know, it's only for a little bit of time. You get what I'm saying? It's until you get where you need to be.